Sweetcian from Queens, New York. I'm a photo designer, and you are too, or maybe you are.
It's gonna be sick.
Photo designer, I thought about it. It was literally a joke until I started posting it on my Instagram and people were like, yo, I relate to that. And I was like, really? And then they were like, yes, it helps me like feel more like, cause I feel like all the time people are looking for like labels and shit. Like, and I don't like calling myself a photographer because like the people that I look up to that are photographers put in years, you know, like Jürgen Teller and David LaChapelle and like Annie Leibovitz, like, not to say that you can't call yourself a photographer, just me personally, I didn't feel comfortable and I still don't. So I was like, I'll make up my own thing as a joke. And then a lot of people were like, yo, this actually helps. Cause like, there's all these like different obstacles, you know? And one of them is like, what do I do? And it's like, you don't have to do anything. You don't have to be anything. You don't have to be like, I take photos of rappers or I take this and that. You know, like you could just be what you are, you know? Once you understand that that's an obstacle that's like wasting your time, then you could just move on and do some other shit. So like photo designer is kind of like, it's supposed to help remove obstacles for people, you know? Like, so you could just like get straight into the art, you know? Like, I feel like there's so many obstacles. The way I look at it, it just kind of is like a waste of time trying to like think about what you are before you do it rather than like do something and then figure it out afterwards, you know? And like if photo designer, like a term that I like just like made up, helps people do that, then I'll promote it. At the end of the day, I wanna like give back all, like I wouldn't be in this position without massive influence and inspiration from like people that I like look up to. And like I feel like nowadays people are like, I don't even know if insecure is the right word, but they just like don't want to be like, I was influenced, or they want to like, everyone wants to be like, I'm original. And it's like, we're not, you know? And that's okay. Let's just like stop pretending, you know? Let's just like be like, someone influenced you to get into the place that you're at. You're not, it's just, they did, you know? The sooner, that's another obstacle where it's like the wrong use of energy. I don't know, I could talk about this shit for days. You guys said introduce myself, I'm talking about. I still don't feel like that. Now I'm like, okay, there's certain things that I do that work, but like, I feel like the moment you get comfortable is the moment like you let your ego take over, and the moment you get comfortable is the moment that you start to slip. Like I'm nowhere where I want to be. That's not to take away from anything or be like, oh, I'm not doing good right now. I'm doing great. I don't know. You just got to stay humble and just remember where you came from. You can't keep going up unless you keep doing what you did. There was a point where I was like getting successful and I kind of started slowing down, and then things started to feel weird and not the same. And I was like, hold on, wait a minute. Let me take it back a second. And I just stopped saying yes to commercial work and just like realized that everything that I have came from nothing, where I was just like in my room in Queens with an idea. I figured out like an aesthetic that works. Commercial people see the aesthetic and they're like, oh cool, like some vintage 90s ads, like inspired thing, you know? And I hate that because like it's not. So I was like, I need to take it back and prove that it's not, even if it's just to myself. Form without function is vanity. You can't have an aesthetic that doesn't have a purpose without it being like waste. You know, we're like so oversaturated right now. It's just like unjust as like a human to continue to like add to that like pile of waste, you know? So like instead of doing something because you feel like you have to do it, you should do it because you want to do it. But nah, like for sure, like there's moments in my career where I'm like, damn, that was fucking sick. Like my favorite moment of my career so far is this coffee truck, because like it's just fun. So much fun gets taken out of things because of like stress and this, that, and the third. And it's like, I don't know, having something that's stress-free, but it's fun and like authentic and like it just happens is just like a blessing, you know? I don't know, for me, it was honestly like the influences, you know? Like I didn't know what I wanted until I saw something that was cool, you know? Like seeing images that are cool, like really inspired me to just make cool images, you know? And then like break down, like what's cool about this? Okay, cool, the lighting, the angle, this, that, and the third, the fact that it's a little weird, like, you know, okay, so now that I broke it down, it's like, how do I do that? You know, how do I use these, like, benchmarkers that I've, like, set by studying work as like, okay, when I'm on set or I'm shooting, make sure this looks good, make sure this looks good. Like, how do I like use that to start executing ideas? Because like an idea is only as good as the execution. You can have the sickest idea and you execute it poorly, it's not gonna translate. And it takes, the only way to get better at execution is through like trial and error. Cause then you find out what works and find out what doesn't work real fast, you know? And then you just implement it next time, you know? And if you're just aware and you're conscious while you're doing everything, just don't hold yourself back because you feel like you're not thinking about something enough, you know? Like I thought at one point, I was like, what's my style? I was like, do I do this, this? And then I was like, wait a minute, I don't need a style. I don't have a style. You know, like my personal style changes every day. You know, like I wake up and someday I feel like this, this. You know, personally, like this year I've been wearing all white every single day. Everything is so vain nowadays and it's all about logos and shit. I'm like, real style doesn't take any logos, you know? And I'm not gonna say that on my Instagram story and then sound like a pretentious guy. I'm like, I'm gonna show you. You know, I'm just not gonna wear logos for a whole year. Just wear all white all year long, you know? And I love it. And I feel like I will never go back to wearing color, but I miss it. The next one I'm shooting, I don't even know what it is, but I'm always excited for the next thing. I really love all of the work that I've been creating recently. I'm really proud of myself. I feel like I've gotten really good at what I do, but I'm like, I'm so like, people offer me like incredible opportunities to direct all the time, feature films and huge budgets and music videos and commercials and this, that, and the third. And I'm just like, I do photos, you know, like I'm sticking to that and I don't want to take away from someone who does video or something like this. So like, I'll do video, but it's not what I do. I take photos, you know. I'm here to like revolutionize the photo. Like the photo is way more powerful than we understand it. So I'm here to show people how powerful the photo is. And it's just through like, I guess, photo design, you know, like it's a new genre really. Well, that's like a paintbrush. I just like film because that's what I started on. And it just looks better, but like I shoot a lot of shit on digital too. Like I think that if you have to like lean on an aesthetic too much, then you should probably reevaluate because you're probably not gonna have longevity, you know? Take everything I say with a grain of salt. I don't wanna be responsible. But film is like a paintbrush to me, you know? It's like you use different paintbrushes for different feelings. You use different canvases for different feelings. So each camera is like, you know, I know what I've been shooting for a long time, like 6 to 8 years, like, you know, in comparison to real photographers, not that long. But, you know, I've started to understand how each camera feels and how each lens feels, and it's all part of the process though. But like, you can't, like, if you only have access to a shitty iPhone, that's what you should use, you know? Like, you shouldn't wait to be like, all right, I'm gonna wait till I get my camera to start taking photos. If you have a vision, you don't need anything other than the simplest tool, you know? Whereas like, my vision is like, I started out with the simple tools and now it's like evolving, you know? So if you have like an elevated vision, you have to like figure out how you can get from point A to point B with what you have. You know, I feel like a lot of people are like, all right, how do I get a point A to point B without all of this stuff? And it's like, you don't need it because you're only going from A to B. You're not going from A to Z. You don't want to go from A to Z because if you go from A to Z, that means you're going up instantly and then there's only one place to go from up and is down. If you're in this right now, think about longevity. I feel like a lot of people aren't thinking about longevity, and it's not good to like stress yourself out, but at least be conscious of it, you know? Everything, man, like New York, really, like my friends, my loved ones, my family. Yeah, I'm really blessed to be like surrounded by a lot of like positive people. Austin Aspizza, like, learned the most from him, and I still learn, and he's younger than me, you know? Like, that kid's really like something special, and people will see that. They already do see it, but like how impactful and special he really is will be revealed through time, you know? And just like real life, like living experiences, like having fun, you know? Vibing out, just like living life, you know? That's really what inspires me to like keep going hard, is like having fun, really. Well, I do a lot of like commercial photography. Lately, when I do commercial work, the brands are coming directly to me. So normally it's like, for people who aren't in the industry, it works like this normally. There's the brand, there's the agency in between, and then there's the photographer. The brand usually has like a loose vibe of what they're going for. Then they contact the agency that they think can execute it for them, and the agency hires the photographer. In the case with something like Nike, they come directly to me. There's no one in between, so I'm doing everything. I have an incredible team. You know, I'm doing exactly what I'm supposed to be doing, but I'm also hiring everyone. and I'm putting the entire vision together. That's what Clover Coffee is like, it's just a project for me. You know, the same way like you look at a campaign, that's a project, or I shoot an album cover, that's a project. After I opened it, I realized, I was like, oh shit. I was like, fuck, now I have a coffee business. I didn't even think about it like that. I was like, I just want to have a cool coffee stand. Like the coffee cart is like a prop to me, you know, it's like, I can use it in different ways and it's like a real life prop. But now I'm like, damn, okay, I have a coffee business. So that's cool. So I've been trying to figure out how to like run that. My boy Kenny, some around here, he's holding it down for me. This is Kenny. Say what's up.
Hey, my name is Kenny Nguyen. I am 23. But yeah, I work for Kian though. I'm like his assistant. I help him out with a lot of photography stuff, but also like a lot of his personal stuff as well, like with the, especially with Clover. Yeah, I've been working a lot mainly with Clover as well. So it's been fun. Yeah.
You wanna tell us how you met Kian?
Yeah. I was listening to this podcast called Throwing Fits, and Kian had gone on this podcast. He went on the podcast and he said that he needed an assistant. And I was like, wow, that's crazy. Like, and I just like just really liked how Kian talked, you know. He was like just like a natural talker, and he just seemed like we'd be friends, you know, like in that aspect. So that's like something I always kept in like the back of my head. I remember Kian saying he needed a personal assistant, and then I went on YouTube and I typed in his name. I was watching this video that he made in 2014 of Camp Woodward. I was like just watching it and I was like laughing, and then I just like sent him a picture of me watching the video, and I also included, I was like, hey, like if you're looking for an assistant still, like let me know. And then like we just ended up just like talking. And then we hopped on a phone call, and then that phone call just ended up turning into like a FaceTime. We were just like talking like we were just like friends. And then he's like, yeah, like the best advice I can give you is just to pull up. He's like, pull up on Monday, and this is Wednesday. I got here on Friday. I was like staying with some friends. I linked with Kian. We did that shoot for Crown Royal Monday, and then like the rest is history. And we just been working. I guys been like his assistant pretty much since then.
Come by, grab a cup, and have fun. Just be happy and have fun. It's easier said than done. It really is. But you have to want it, you know? The same way with everything. You want to be successful, you have to really want it and work for it, you know? You want to be happy, you got to really want it and work for it. Just work hard. Never get comfortable. Clover mode.